Three. Sons and daughters of the faith, grace to you. Blessed be the name of the Lord God, Yeshua the Christ. I am delighted to be involved in the celebration of this church's 120th year established in this community. A church building for the born again, spirit baptized souls who have assembled on these hallowed ground for 120 years of celebration. If not these grounds, at least in the area, the sons and daughters. Now we know that the church is a body of baptized believers, the ecclesia, the called out assembly, if you please. And so here we are now in the spring of 2022. We are inheritors of a great and noble legacy. So I am pleased to offer this presentation of the establishment of Second Baptist Church Monrovia, an evangelical Orthodox parish, from the spring of 1902, where two or three gathered to establish a parish church of sanctified people, later through hard labor, faith, love, and devotion, sacrifice, perseverance, they erected a building to the glory of God, where the people could come and gather in assembly and worship God in spirit, that is faith, and in truth, according to his blessed word. So since that time, just think about it, thousands have been blessed, born again, administered the ordinance of water baptism as an outward sign of an inward work of grace, babies dedicated unto the Lord, people discovered their spiritual gifts and sanctified in holy matrimony, healing has taken place of their bodies, and of course, we have bid it so many good night and told them we'll see you in the morning as they are in the presence of Almighty God. And all of that is based on the passage of scripture in Ephesians chapter 2, verses 20 through 24 of the New King James Version. The church is a body of baptized believers, called out ones, assembly. And that is the reason that I love to use the word church. Since we have been given the opportunity to exercise our spiritual gifts, many have found their places in life, and many have been used of God in song, in teaching, in leadership, and in praise that brought blessing to young, middle adults, and older ones for the glory of God. Oh, what a marvelous moment. And just to think, it has all been etched on God's record of every son and every daughter. Now the above more and more, because of Jesus the Christ, he said it to Simon Peter in the book of Matthew chapter 16. He said to him, "And I also say to you that you are Peter, and on this rock I will build my church, and the gates of Hades shall not prevail against it." Matthew 16, 18, New King James Version. This is the word of the Lord. Now God spoke through the eminent apostle Paul. He says, "Now therefore, you are no longer strangers and foreigners, but fellow citizens with the saints and members of the household of God, having been built on the foundation of the apostles and prophets, Jesus Christ himself being the chief cornerstone, in whom the whole building being fit together grows into a holy temple in the Lord, in whom you also are being built together for a dwelling place of the God in the Spirit. Ephesians 2, 2 through 22 of the New King James Version. This is the word of the Lord. Now think about it, the figure of the church as a temple. Christ is the cornerstone. The apostles and New Testament prophets are the foundation builders. And each saint is a stone in the building, according to 1 Peter chapter 2, 4 through 8. Just think about it. Where are you as a stone in the building? Now the real church is in your heart, and you are a stone in the building, and Jesus Christ is the foundation. The apostles and prophets, they built on that foundation, and here we are now, inheritors of such a great and noble faith. 120 years, this is our time, this is our place, this is what God wants, and he wants to use every one of you. Please continue to be Bible-centered in everything, and let your words, your deeds, and your actions have the authority of the word of God behind it. And if it does not have the authority of the word of God, then don't say it, because we are ambassadors of Christ. We are representing him for all eternity. We want to be accurate, because Jesus says, "And you shall know the truth, and the truth shall set you free." This is the word of God from John 8 and 32. The blessings of the Lord now rest upon you as we celebrate this 120th year. God be glorified until he comes. I am serving Christ joyfully. Amen. Thank you for letting me share.